Quai des Polars.
Quai du Polar.
Quai du Polar.
Quai du Polar.
Quai du Polar.
So Sebastian Bergman is the kind of anti-hero of our books. He's a forensic psychologist. And in the first book, when we meet him, he's not really doing anything. He lost his wife and his daughter in the tsunami in 2004. And after that, he just kind of lost motivation. So when we meet him in the first book, he's not doing anything. His parents just died, so he's going to sell their house. And at the same time, there's an investigation, a murder investigation, that his old team is doing in his home city. So he's being drawn into that. So that is a little bit who he is. He's kind of a hopeless person. He's great at his work. He's a really good psychologist, but he can't really fix himself. He is constantly choosing, taking the wrong choices in life. If there's a right and there's a wrong, he will 100% choose the wrong, because he feels like he needs to punish himself for he couldn't save his daughter in the tsunami. So he doesn't deserve happiness, I think, is a kind of key element with him. He doesn't think he deserves happiness. So he's a bit, he's rude, he doesn't like authorities, he's a sex addict, I think our publishing house said he's a person that you'd love to hate. We love him a lot, of course, but he's a difficult genius, you might say. And so he's going to reunite with his old team, where he has where there's two female detectives and two male detectives, and they are traveling around in Sweden, solving murders, but they're not located anywhere, so we move around in Sweden with them. And he started out as a TV series, Sebastian. Michael, who's my colleague, produced a TV show called Valander, based on the Mankell books. And after that, our main lead actor there, Rolf Lassgård, they wanted to continue to work together. So we decided to create a show for him, and he didn't want to be a police officer anymore, because he'd done 10 Valander films. So, and we wanted to do a thriller. So we made him a forensic psychologist, and he didn't want to be, because Kurt Wallander is kind of easy to like. So Rolf asked us, is it possible to do this character perhaps a little harder to like, a little more dark and brooding perhaps? And so we threw pretty much all the bad habits we could think of on him, and most of them stuck. And then we went to the TV company, SVT, who wanted it. But when we brought it to them, they didn't want it anymore. And we thought it was still a good idea. We liked the team, we liked our story. So then we decided to turn it into a book instead. And now it's a book series. We just published our sixth one in Sweden in November. The fourth one is out here in France. La Fille Muette, our latest book in French, starts with the massacre of a family, two children and a mother and a father in a secluded house in Värmland, which is a place in Sweden, let's settle for that. So it starts with that, and since it's a major crime in a very small village, they ask for help from our team, so they go over. And it turns out that there has been a witness to this crime. The boys who are dead, they had a cousin there over Easter holiday. And she saw the killing, and now she's disappeared. So it's for the police to try to find her before the killer does and try to silence her. And it's also a personal thing for Sebastian, because this girl is in the same age as his daughter would have been. And he is very determined not to let another girl die if he can prevent it. So it's getting very personal for him to try to find this girl, and if or when they find her, also trying to make her speak. Because, yeah, spoiler, they will find her, but she won't talk because she's traumatized. That's hence the title. So Sebastian is really making an effort into kind of to connect with this girl and her mother.